Hello, friends of the Northern Entertainment, and welcome to first episode of Derail Valley, a game released by the end of January in early access, a game that is marketed as a VR game, and unfortunately, by doing so, I think they are making one big mistake because they are cutting out a whole bunch of potential customers like myself who don't have VR. That being said, though, as you can see, I'm playing the game and it plays very well. So let's just get started. I'm just gonna go here over my day. We're gonna talk a little bit about the game, and yeah, I do hope you guys have fun. If you like the video, yeah, you know what to do. Like, hit the like button. If you dislike the video, well, you know also what to do. Dislike the video, please. And if you haven't done so already, please subscribe to my channel to see more videos like this. That being said, let's talk about the game. So the game is made by a small team of 5 developers. The map is 256 square kilometers, and there are about 200 kilometers of rail on this. As you can see, it is a closed net, and also there is here is the industry chain. As you can see, the normal industry chain is from the forest, we go to the sawmill. From the sawmill, the products go to the goods factory, from the goods factory to the town or to the harbor, and so on and so on and so on. You can see there is a fully fleshed out industrial chain, farm, oil wells, coal mines, iron ore, steel mills, harbor, food factory, town, goods factory, and machine factory, and so on. And I have to say, because this is made for VR, it has a couple of things that I wish that other simulators had too. Like, for example, this right here. See, this is how the jobs look like. And if you want a job, let me just see here. So here, for example, let's start with this. This is fairly straightforward. It's a shunting job. Actually, give me one sec here. This one here has to go now into the garbage can because I picked it up. Otherwise, it's going to end up in my inventory. So, load and prepare a train with steel rings for departure to Harbor Town. That starts with step 1. Couple to CFF 14, 15, 16, 17, and 18 on track 4. So, let's go. Now, because this is in a VR environment, or meant to be played in a VR environment, we can do certain things, like with F, you have this blue button, and that warps you through the world, which I use that too. I will say that much right now. The while it is detailed, it is not on a level of Train Sim World, obviously. It's not meant to be. It's different. If you would play this into VR, then VR is really the experience that you are aiming for. And, yeah, there are just some things that are different, as I said. So we do have a map here. This is, of course, our normal map. Then we have a station map. We are right now in the steel mill. Sawmill, steel mill. So you can see here, we are coupling on OS4. That's actually nice, because that means we don't even have to go to the main trunk. We're just gonna probably see them right there somewhere. Yep, there they are. Our empty cars. So we're just gonna let her roll out here. There we go. Apply a little bit of brake, come to a gentle stop, and then we can roll back. Now you have also keyboard shortcuts that you can use. Now this is going to be easy money. So, let's see here. We wanna go... Oh wait, this is S2, never mind. My bad. That's what I get for assuming. This is S4 over there. Okay, well, that's easy enough to fail. Ah, ha, 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 ha. Wrong button. That's what I wanted. Okay, so we have to roll out a little bit further. But yeah, the graphics, as I said, are not Train Sim World, but that's not what they are meant to be. The game, however, is fun, even though at the moment, anyways, and it's all on the roadmap, and I will link to the roadmap down in the description below, but in the roadmap, it shows you what they are planning in terms of... what they are planning in terms of signals and whatnot. Passenger traffic at the moment is not available either. But that all will come. The game is getting regular updates. And when I say regular updates, we are talking updates to the tune of about 2 to 3 updates a month. They might just be small updates, but... they are good updates, I find. $15 is fast enough for this little shunter here. And boy oh boy did I work this shunter hard. Like I did stuff There we go. I hope that's the right one. It's 18, that's hopefully 17. Alright, so obviously the coupling is not the most realistic the way you can do this, but that's okay too. As I've said, there's certain things that that are simplified, that have to be simplified. Oh yeah, we should maybe look also L6. Yeah, that's kind of what I thought, because usually the loading is done on Lima 6, at least here in the steel mill. And interestingly enough, that's where I spent a good part of the 9 hours that I played this game so far. Is just on the steam mill shunting stuff back and forth, which made me pretty... I know the station pretty well by now. I just didn't pay attention here earlier, really. Because most of the shunting takes place out there. But yeah, you have to get a whole bunch of... now you have to get a whole bunch of licenses too. It's probably far enough. If this train would have been loaded, we might have gotten ourselves here in a little bit of trouble right now. Now we're gonna push back into Lima 6, which is where we're gonna load it, and then we have to bring the whole works to Oscar 12. Oscar 12 is this one there, I think. No, that's 13. That one. So we're gonna have to push train a little bit ahead. We believe, let's see here, station map. Oscar 12, yeah, that's this one. This is 12, 13, 14. 14 is the one furthest. And then I'm gonna show you guys this steam engine over here, because I don't think there's any big diesel engines or electric engines. This is all written down on the... Well, diesel engines, I can't be sure, because there is also something that you can unlock for 65,000, which is another train, apparently, or another engine. I have no idea what kind of engine it is, though. But the sounds are really good. The sounds I really like. What I would really like to see is more detail on the engine in terms of light. Although I do know that Shanta is not necessarily conformed to normal light standards, but the Steam logo, for example, has no lights whatsoever. And that is, I think, something where potential, or potential for greatness, if you will, is wasted. This... No, you don't... This is how you load. Easy, eh? See, now we have steel beams on here. Are those rails? Yeah. So we have cargo steel rails, 46,000 kgs, so 46 tons, with a mass of 11 tons of the cart on top of that. So we're ending up with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carts times 56, 57. And then you have the total weight of the train. And I did it again. Forgot to... And now you see how this poor little engine has to really work. Oh yeah, diesel engine, as you can see, because she's smoking. Well, you can hear it as well, but I just wanted to point out you have smoke coming out of the stack. Now, it seems like the flap on the exhaust is based on speed of the train total and not like it should really be on now on the speed of the engine, on the RPM on the engine. Actually, now we just let the train go by because we do not have at this point a remote control for the shunter. That again is something that's on the roadmap. And I'm looking forward to this. I'm definitely going to keep covering this game. As I said, this weekend I played it quite extensively. The reason I, well, you guys probably know that anyway, but the reason that I had the brakes still engaged while starting to give it a little bit of throttle is because I didn't want to... Oh, I just realized something. Don't mind me here. Yeah, I know, those procedures are not exactly up to... CN rail code, but as I said before, you have to kind of it's a give and take in terms of realism with this game, but it's fun, and that's the thing, it is fun, and that's the first thing that's important for a game as far as I'm concerned, and probably you would agree there. My aim is off. There, and then this one is right. Okay, so I can go back to my train. This is where really... Oh yeah, sounds. Let's see. You can really see that nicely here when it comes to this very connection. Now listen. Okay, I have to get into the machine. How fast are we going? Yeah, we definitely want to slow down some. Around 5 kilometers per hour. And we do not have an independent brake. All right. So let's connect here. Three, two. You're gonna see here 6 meters, 4, 3, 2, 1, and connected. All right. Now this train is a lot heavier. A lot heavier. I just want to make sure that we get it, that we get the whole consist back enough in so it's clear of I-10. Oh, sorry, I-11. Oh no, this is the main trunk that we are on still. Ha! So we definitely want to be clear. Oh yeah, we have plenty of space there too. So we should be able to get the shunter even off the tracks without having to move the shunter back. Because you can see here we have plenty of space yet. Oh, that would be an interesting train to haul, but not exactly what I'm looking forward to here right now. Once I'm gonna show you guys the steam loco. I'm probably not going to be able to finish that run this episode anyway, but it's all good. And the derailment physics, I have to say, they are quite impressive. Because I have to admit, I derailed one or two or maybe four trains already. That's far enough. That is far enough. Yeah. There. In here. And looky here, 2500. Thank you. That means we have now 5400. That's about 10% of where we have to be to get old Bob's garage key. I can't wait to see what's in there, but again, that won't be today. Empty cars to the coal mine. Steel mill. $240 tons. That's two different brains that they put together, I think. So they are all on track S8, are they? Okay, so our empty cars to the coal mine. Step one, couple the following consist. Cars, sorry, at station Sierra 8. And then it's already hauling. Okay, that sounds good to me. That's what we'll do. And this is something we could have done with... okay, I need the station map though. 8. Sierra 8 is the one right beside us here. We are on Papa 7. So Sierra 8 is literally this one here. This is the train that we have to hook up to. Now since we have to go... Let me check the consist here quickly before anything else. And I will be back with you guys once that is done. Alright, so. It is indeed the consist we have to hook up to. And... as you can see here, we are hauling this to the coal mine. Now the coal mine, in turn, is... Oh, this is where the coal mine is, okay. So it would almost make sense, I think, to turn the engine around. Before we do anything else. That's what we're gonna do, because I don't want to haul backwards the whole way up there. And I also don't want to have to... I really don't want to have to... turn this whole train around. That just seems like a lot of work for nothing. So, then... let us get started. Regulator all the way back. Open that. Gonna start filling the water. And this is where the shovel comes in. And what a terrible, terrible shovel that is. Worst mechanic. I really, really wish there was a different way to do this. Also, this thing, as you will see, goes through coal like nobody's business. What are we doing here? Okay. That's good enough. Now we shall throw a lighter. Yeah, I can't. Obviously, I can't move forward with a lighter the way you should. Look how quickly the coal is disappearing, though. Insane! You spend all your time feeding this fire. This is where multiplayer would be really handy, too. Okay, let's turn the blower on, because we are not moving at the moment. Blower is on, water is full. Steam is building. Wonderful. We can just shovel and shovel and shovel and shovel. Every day I'm shoveling. It's shuffling. All good. Alright, we have more than enough steam now in the boiler. So, we're gonna open up the brakes. And off we go. There is not enough steam. What's going on here? Now, unfortunately, I can't really toot the horn either, toot the whistle either, but... all good. So we are going 20 kilometers at the moment. there is not enough steam on the Steam engine. And I do hope that that is something that will be changed, will be fixed, and rather sooner than later too. I'm so sad that I can't use the whistle on this. This would be epic, but again, soon. See what I mean? There is the, what should be really, what's the best part about driving a steam engine is the steam, and that we do not have. We certainly see only when you get into the engine you can actually use the whistle. Come on. Nope. Oh yeah, also I can turn the blower off. And there is no... no coal left whatsoever. Okay. Yeah. Well, now we have some steam coming out anyway. But that steam out here shouldn't be... well, anyways. Neither here or there. And it's early access, so we'll have to keep that in mind. Like, the burn rate is insane of the coal. Now, one of the things that I do remember from other train sims is always the one of the things that you have to always keep in mind is to get the water drain. You have the water approximately as fast draining as you burn through it, so that it's equaled out. What happened to my coal? Now, I cannot open the damper. I don't know if that's a bug or whatnot. But this here, this is the damper. And I cannot, just like with the whistle, I cannot use that in any way, shape, or form. Which I should be able to, but... Okay, we are building steam again. I might as well turn the blower back up. A little bit anyway. And this is really... The water cock is... Where all the fine adjustment has to be made. Because you don't definitely don't want to have too much water, because then the steam is not produced efficiently. But on that same token, you don't want to have too little water, because then you are running into problems in terms of oh, it looks like now we have all of a sudden steam coming out like it's supposed to. Oh, well, what do you know? I take everything back. There is all of a sudden the steam that I was looking for. Maybe I wasn't efficient enough the way I did run the steam. You know what? I'm starting to think that the problem was not the engine at all, but was how I was running the engine. I'm starting to wonder if that's maybe the case. No, I didn't mean to fall out of my... open this a little more. What a dump. What's this? I wonder what this is. Hopefully not the water dump, but I should maybe not play around with buttons that I do not know the All right, so this is where we have to hook up. Yeah, it would appear that the consumption now is a lot more reasonable. All right. Let's hook up here. And this is probably going to be the rest for today. There we go. Okay. There is our empty train. Where's the steam release? Steam dump. Right. We're good there. Turn that a little bit down. Don't want to have... Okay, first of all, we are hooked up to our consist. I'm gonna put some more coal on the fire. And then we are off to the races. I wish we could go, woo-hoo, but no. All right. Well, friends, I think this will be it. So I do hope you enjoyed it and you will join me again next time. But until then, Northern Alex signing off. Thank you so much for watching and God bless.